What's going on, guys? My name's Theo Atrix.
Hi, and welcome to my guide.
Today, we'll be going through the achievement diaries that every main account should aim to complete. Each diary boasts a broad range of benefits and buffs to your account, ranging from skilling, bossing, and PVM improvements, unlocking teleports and shortcuts all around RuneScape, as well as giving access to a range of powerful money-making methods. In order to maximize your account's potential on old school, diaries are almost necessary, otherwise you're playing at a large disadvantage.
We will be going through each achievement diary, highlighting the best and essential rewards for each region.
The Ardoin Diary provides a broad range of skilling benefits to your account. After the Easy Diary, the Ardi Cape 1 provides unlimited teleports to the monastery south of Ardi. This is handy for low levels, allowing easy access to the nearby altar and also the nearby fairy ring.
You also get a range of thieving boosts. After the Easy Diary, there's a 10% chance that the guards will ignore you when you're thieving from a stall in the marketplace. With the Medium Diary, there's a 10% greater chance of not getting caught when pickpocketing anyone in Ardoin. With the Hard Diary, that 10% chance is changed to anywhere in RuneScape, not just Ardoin.
From Medium through to Elite, you can use the cape to teleport to the Ardoin allotment and herb patch to the northeast of the city, which is an essential teleport for increasing the efficiency of your herb runs. The Medium Diary only allows 3 teleports per day, whereas the Elite has unlimited charges.
By talking to Wizard Cromperty in the house northeast of the marketplace, you can claim free pure essence every day with up to 250 with the Elite Diary. This is great for Ironmen to gradually get the essence they need for runecrafting training.
The monsters that you can spawn in the Tower of Life are a great way for low-level Ironmen to get the secondary supplies for herb lore. With the Medium Ardoin Diary, the drops become noted, allowing you to stay here for far longer.
With the Elite Diary, Bird delivers 84 buckets of sand to your bank every single day for free, just as long as you log in that day. This allows Ironmen to easily train their crafting, since sand is an ingredient used when making molten gloss.
The Varrok Achievement Diary is another essential one for your account.
With each diary tier, you can purchase more and more battle staffs each day from Zaf for a flat rate of 7k each. Battle staffs are worth over 8,000 each on the Grand Exchange, so it becomes a great daily money-making method. With the Easy Diary, you can make around 16,000 per day, scaling all the way up around 130,000 for the Elite Diary. If you did this every single day for 30 days, you would profit 3.9 million. Which is almost enough for a bond.
With the Medium Varrok Diary, you can change the Varrok teleport location to the Grand Exchange. You can also use a Varrok teleport portal in your house to get to the GE, and it's a lot closer to a bank than the standard Varrok teleport. While you wear Varrok armor, which is the reward from completing each tier, you get both smithing and mining XP boosting effects.
You get a 10% chance of mining 2 ores at once, and you get experience for both of the ores that you get. So overall, you get 10% more XP per hour. Each tier of armor only works up to a certain type of ore though. Tier 1 allows double ore for anything up to gold, tier 2 works up to mithril and also works with granite and sandstone, tier 3 works up to adamant, tier 4, so elite, works with any type of ore. However, none of these work in the model load mine, blast mine, or with mining essence, so the best use is with power mining iron or granite. Tier 4 armor also works in place of the prospector plate body, so you can use this with a set of prospector to get the bonus XP from the outfit.
With the Varrok armor, there's also a 10% chance of smelting 2 ores at once, and you get the full experience. Again though, each armor only works up to a certain tier of metals, with the same tiers as the mining benefits, so working its way up from gold. The Western Provinces Diary provides a broad range of PVM benefits for your account. There's very few benefits from the Easy and Medium Diaries, but the Hard and Elite tier make this diary very worth your time.
After finishing the hard diary, you can upgrade your regular void to elite void, which provides higher damage and accuracy bonuses than the standard counterpart, but also gives you prayer bonus. This is an essential set for PVM, being the best in slot for a range of bossing challenges.
Also after the hard diary, you can buy a Crystal Halberd from Isselwyn outside of Laletia. The Halberd's special attack is among the strongest in the game for high level bosses, dealing huge amounts of damage while only consuming 30% of your special attack energy. Again with the hard diary, you can access the private Red Chinchomper hunting grounds in the Feldip Hills. This is a small cave located southeast of the regular Red Chinchomper area. This cave gets you away from the large number of bots that hunt in the regular region. There's also more Chinchompers around, as well as walls around the area, so the Chins can't walk very far away, overall boosting your XP rates.
With the elite diary, if you die at Zolra, you get one free resurrection per day. This is extremely useful for hardcore Ironmen, greatly reducing the risk of losing the status if they make a mistake. You also get more Slayer points from Neve or Steve from the Elite Diary. Instead of the standard 12 points per task, it gets increased to 15, which is the same as Durdal.
The Chompy Chick is a pet that's only obtainable after the Elite Diary. Without the diary, there's no chance to get the pet from hunting Chompies. And after you do the diary, it's only a 1 in 500 chance, making it a fairly fast pet to obtain. Also with Elite, it's guaranteed that 2 Chompy birds will spawn instead of 1 when you lure them with bloated toads. The lower tiers of the diary also give you a chance of 2 spawning, but it's not guaranteed.
The Mauritania Achievement Diary is another one that gives huge benefits, but mostly with the higher tiers. Slaying monsters in the Slayer Tower after the diary gives you an XP boost ranging from 2.5% to 10% from easy to elite. From the Medium Diary, you're able to get 3 buckets of slime and trade bones for bone meal from Robin, which can quickly be used at the Ectofunctus for fast prayer experience and Ecto tokens.
The rune drops from Barrows is what makes the minigame a more consistent moneymaker. From the hard diary, you get 50% more runes from Barrows chests, which not only makes the money more consistent, it's a great source of combat runes for Ironmen as well. After the hard diary, the Mauritania legs will teleport you to Berg de Rot an infinite number of times per day. This is useful to access temple trekking, the nearby bank, and can also be used to get to Barrows.
Also after the hard diary, you're given a bone crusher, and while holding this in your inventory, it automatically crushes bones you get as drops from monsters. With the hard diary, the bones give half the burying experience, whereas elite, it's the full amount. The bone crusher is charged with ecto tokens, and using the free slimes and bone meal from Robin is a great way to gain charges.
With the Elite Diary, you gain access to a new herb patch on Harmony Island, which increases your potential profit from every herb run that you do. The Lumbridge and Draenor Achievement Diary has a few benefits and one essential reward in particular.
After the medium tier, the Explorer's Ring is able to teleport you to the Cabbage Patch south of Falador. This is right next to the Herb and Allotment Patch, and there's no other teleports nearby, so this is essential for herb runs.
The Explorer's Ring also has 2 other benefits. Firstly, it can replenish your run energy, increasing with each diary tier. This is handy for various activities, like questing or for farm runs.
The ring can also be used to cast alchemy without using any runes. After the easy diary, the ring has 30 low alchemy charges, and with the elite, it becomes 30 high alchemy charges. This is great for bursting Slayer tasks, where you're on the ancient spellbook, and it allows you to alk a lot of the drops you get without having to change spellbook. After the hard diary, you receive 10% more experience from Tears of Kha'Zix, and since you get a lot of experience, 10% is quite a bonus.
the Elite Diary gives you an extra blocking slot for Slayer tasks, and it also allows you to use Fairy Rings without the use of a Draymon staff. Both of these are by no means essential, but they both greatly improve your overall efficiency. The Kandarin Diary gives a range of skilling benefits.
Completing the Kandarin Diary increases your chances of saving a harvest life at the Gatherby Herb Patch. The bonuses start from the Medium Diary and scale from 5% to 15% when you reach Elite.
After the Hard Diary, you can toggle the Camelot teleport location to be outside the Seer's Village Bank. This makes the Seer's Rooftop Agility course significantly faster, since after you finish the course, you can use the teleport to be right back at the start, removing the need to run back to the beginning. With this teleport, the Seer's Rooftop course is the fastest agility XP in the game from levels 60 to 72.
Completing the Hard Kandarin Diary also increases the reward points you get from Barbarian Assault by 10%, which is great for speeding up the elite task of getting to level 5 in every role. Next up is the Falador Diary, and this one provides a range of PVM and skilling benefits. After the Medium Diary, the Allotment, Herb and Flower Patch outside of Falador give 10% more experience. Not a huge bonus, but it's still nice to have.
The Hard Diary provides a range of helping tools for fighting the Giant Mole. The Falador Shield 3 gives you an indication of the Giant Mole's location by showing a red arrow on your mini-map. Without the locator, finding the Giant Mole can be a huge pain. And also with Hard, you get noted mole parts as drops, allowing you to stay here for a lot longer than you previously could.
After each tier, you are awarded with a Falador Shield, and by using its Recharge Prayer option, you can recharge a percentage of your prayer points, which can be useful for bossing and long PVM challenges like the Inferno. The Elite Shield restores your prayer points to full twice per day, which is equivalent to almost 2 prayer potions.
With the Elite Falador Diary, the tree patch in the park permanently becomes disease-free. This reduces the cost of the patch by a mile, since you won't ever need to pay the gardener again. The Kuren Diary is another one that has both PVM and skilling bonuses. After the Medium Diary, there's a 5% chance that you mine double the essence when you're doing runecrafting on Zaya. This can slightly speed up your runecrafting XP rates.
After the Hard Diary, the Slayer Helmet acts as a Shazian helmet with the full Shazian set. This means that you can use the boost of a Slayer helmet while fighting Lizardmen Shamans on a Slayer task. The Hard Diary also helps with a lot of herb runs, giving you a 5% increased chance of saving a harvest life. This works for both the Hosidius Herb Patch and the Farming Guild one.
Rada's Blessing, the item reward from completing the diary, comes with a range of improvements for your account. It can teleport you to Mount Karulam, near the Slayer Dungeon and Konar. The Hard Diary gives 3 teleports per day, and the Elite upgrades that to unlimited. The Elite Rada's Blessing is also the best in-slot prayer bonus in the game, giving a +2 prayer bonus.
Also with the Elite Diary, you get 10% more blood runes from runecrafting, increasing your overall profit by 10%. You also get 10% reduced burn rate in the Hosidius Kitchen, which is an increase from the standard 5%. This lowers your burn level.
Next is the Karumja Diary, and this one only provides a couple of key unlocks. Within the Brimhaven Agility Arena, if you complete the Medium Diary, you get 10% more agility XP from both the obstacles and for trading in tickets to Jackie. After the Elite Diary, you get double the amount of tickets from the minigame, which in turn makes it one of the fastest agility training methods in the game.
Also with the Elite Diary, the Karumja Gloves can teleport you unlimited times straight to Duradel, allowing you to get a new Slayer task really fast. Next is the Fremenic Achievement Diary.
After completing any tier of the diary, you're rewarded with Fremenic Sea Boots, which allow you to teleport directly to Relica. This is extremely useful for Vorkarth, since the teleport is very close by, but only the Elite tier gives unlimited teleports.
After the hard tier, you can use the Stony Basalt teleport method, which speeds up the time it takes you to get to the herb patch on Troll Stronghold. You can also use the wall climb shortcut near the teleport, which again speeds up the time it takes to get to that patch.
Also with hard, you can use both the Tan Leather and Recharge Dragonstone spell on the Lunar Spellbook. Both of these are profitable ways to train your magic, although they're by no means essential. After the Elite Fremenic Diary, all of the Dagonoth bones that you get from the Dagonoth Kings are automatically noted, allowing you to stay here pretty much endlessly while making a lot of money.
Next up is the Wilderness Diary, providing mostly money-making bonuses.
After the Hard Diary, you can select the teleport location of the Wilderness Obelisks. This saves you from constantly teleporting to get to the correct location, and this also works with an obelisk inside of your player-owned house.
You can use a shortcut to the south of the Lava Dragons after the Hard Diary as well, allowing for an easy escape from PKS. Again, with the Hard Diary, any Wines of Zamorak that you telegraph in the wilderness will automatically be noted, allowing you to collect a lot more than one full inventory.
With the Elite Diary, all dragon bone drops within the wilderness become noted, extending your trips at places like Green Dragons. Last is the Desert Achievement Diary, and it's probably the least useful one out there, with very few benefits. After the Hard Desert Diary, Zaher in Narda can turn noted herbs and vials of water into unfinished potions. This is great for Iron Men to save time with the process that gives no experience. With the Hard Diary, the Calphite Lair in the desert permanently has ropes attached to it, removing the need to bring your own.
Elite also allows you to use a shortcut to Calphite Queen near the entrance of the cave that also requires level 86 agility to do.
So that's the essential achievement diaries in Old School. A huge thank you to Slayer Music for making this video with me. And if you aren't subscribed to him already, make sure you do. The link to his channel is down in the description. Thanks for watching and...
Okay, thanks, bye.